nail hair and day spa, your relaxation and beautification destination. We are a full service salon. Our services include massage therapy, nail services, skincare and makeup, waxing, hair design and color, and men's barbering. Look and feel fabulous at Dream Salon, Nail Hair and Day Spa. Visit us today at 1757 Coney Drive in Belize City.
Good morning and welcome to Morning Matters. This morning it's a Wednesday and we have for you a treat. This will be a norm for you because we figure you deserve it. This is Wellness Wednesday. So good morning and welcome to Wellness Wednesday. Wellness Wednesday is going to be the first segment in our show. This and every Wednesday, at least for the next 6 months. Our guest this morning is Sandra Ballesteros. I hope I have the pronunciation right. Sandra is a licensed cosmetologist from Sandra's Dream Hair, Nail, and Day Spa. All right, if you ever pass Coney Drive, you're going to see her place. Sandra, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Rhonda. I'm okay. Thank you for being here.
Sandra, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where did you grow up and what got you involved in cosmetology?
Born Guatemalan. And I grew up here in Belize with my mother. I didn't continue studying Guatemala, like university or so. So I studied designing and digital photography in Guatemala. Then I came to Belize when I was 17. And I start my life here in Belize with my mom, helping my mom. Then when I start to have my family, I decided to have my own business because being an employee, I think it's for all women will be sometimes difficult because we don't have time for our family or etc. Then I study at Alma's Cosmetologies. And I'm proud of it because I took the best career for me personally because that's my passion. And now my business is 8 years old and I have clients that I help during the 8 years with, especially hair. I study everything, hair, nails, skincare.
You know, Sandra, a lot of people, they go and they take one course from wherever place they go. But I know through my life experience with you is that that is not all you do. You continue to educate yourself.
Yes.
You continue to become, you stay up to date with the latest that is good for you and that kind of stuff. What keeps you committed to this art so much?
I think here, especially in Belize, we have different types of hair. We have afro, we have mix, like it's...
like mine?
We have, yes, we have straight and thin, we have medium hair, we have coarse. So it's very interesting because when you give your clients what they're really looking for, you feel good. So that's why I'm continuing to study more. I assist on seminars like 2 to 3 times per year.
Before we get into the health tips for today, I want people to understand that you are not just a woman that have a salon that comes to work every day. You are invested in this business, and when somebody walks through your door, they can get educated on how to get themselves to wherever they want where beauty is concerned. Regardless of their skin color, their hair texture, whatever it is, you can assist them.
Yes.
Because besides that, you're also a teacher.
Yes, I am. Now I'm a teacher from Ministry of Education, and I will continue to educate more people that wants this opportunity to have to own their own business or to have a better results at the job sites, or if you are a cosmetologist or you call yourself a cosmetologist but you are not certified, you can continue study and certify yourself so you can get, you can earn more money, you can give your clients more the best results that they're looking for. I think it's a great thing.
I think so too, because a lot of times we find that we find ourselves in hair salons where we get the cheapest products, we might be paying the cheapest price, but that is what you get for paying the cheapest products, and we get not necessarily the best results. You know, when my hair was long, I used to have difficulty in where to go and what to buy and what to wash it with, but I fixed that. But a lot of people, even people that have short hair, they want to know the products to make their curls tighter or to make it drop or whatever the case is that they want. They can come to you and get that kind of service.
Yes. Sometimes, well, in my experience, because year per year, you learn different things. And I learned that pollution sometimes damage your hair. Because if you are in the cool, damage your hair. If you are in this heat, it will damage your hair. So how to take care of your hair daily?
How to take care of your hair daily. Let's jump into the first tip on how to take care of your hair daily. This is something that you can do for yourself?
Yes.
Tell me. I want to know.
Well, okay. First thing, a lot of women and men are losing hair. So the topics right now is how to deal with it. So what we should do is wash our hair with mild shampoo.
What is considered mild shampoo? Because for me, I go in the store, I wash my hair every day, I just pick up any shampoo.
Any shampoo.
That's not good.
No.
No. As of today, that will change. What is mild shampoo?
Okay. Mild shampoo, I call this because it's gentle to your hair. If your hair is straight, like mine, it's coarse and straight. This will, I will need a deep cleaner shampoo. Then I need a soft shampoo, sulfate free.
Sulfate free?
Sulfate free.
Why sulfate free?
Because our waters is already
have a lot of sulfate. Sulfide in it.
Then we need a conditioner.
Okay.
Always. Oh. Not conditioner with the shampoo. We need a separate conditioner.
Sandra, and I mean, I would imagine that people with longer hair might use conditioner, but me, I have conditioner in my bathroom and many times I don't use. Do I still need to use?
You need it. You need it because that will moisturize your hair and will prepare your hair to whatever damage comes to your hair, either dust, either the heat, your hair gonna resist it. Because your hair is sealed, your folliculus is sealed, and the whatever dust or so will drop, so it doesn't stick to your hair. Your hair will be, the folliculus will stay sealed, strong. Ah. So because each hair have their own life. If I tell you more, this have keratin, this have, like if you want to like broke it, this will not broke because I treat it.
I see.
I pull it and this is go like
it's
stretching. Yes.
It will not break.
Will not break.
Because you
it's
take
not
good
that
care
easy
of it.
Yes.
And you take care of it by using mild shampoo and conditioner.
Yes.
All the time.
All the time. At least two shampoo and one conditioner you have to have in your bathroom.
Well, the next time you go out to buy conditioner and shampoo, please look at the bottle. Do not pull around the Crichton and just pick up anyone. Because anyone is not good for your hair. Mm-hmm. Well, that's interesting.
Then if you love to color your hair, there is special shampoos for you. Take care of your color. And if you want to style your hair, just wash it, conditioner it, then apply a leave-in cream shampoo, cream. Don't wash it again. Just apply it, then style it. Like your hair, we need a leave-in cream. So that will keep your hair style. Your curls gonna look.
They will look happier.
Exactly.
Well, now I know. Sandra, this is an education for me, and I'm sure it's not only for me, because there are a lot of people that have, like you said, we have all sorts of hair. I have a daughter that's always trying to figure out how to get my hair curly and, or her hair curly and stay, and she's always buying these things, you know. But now she, I would imagine with this conversation, she'll be better able to figure out how to get the kind of hair that she wants. Can somebody walk in here and maybe after they get a service from you, after they get their first service, you can say, this is the shampoo that works best for your hair, so when you are at home, this is what I recommend you use?
Yes, I actually study with bringing products, the best products, professional products. So if it's kind of pricey, but if you can afford it, well, you will take with you the best products. So we offer products as well.
And you offer these products because you have used them?
Yes. And we use it here at the salon. So at home, why not to get a professional treatment at your own house? And you don't have to go to the salon sometimes. If you go to the salon, it's because maybe every 3 months you need a trimming. I recommend that every 3 months. You want your hair grow, trim it every 3 months, and then treat it at least once a month at the beauty salon, a professional salon.
So if I was to walk in here, I would not find the ordinary, for lack of a better term, shampoo on your shelf?
No.
No.
My shampoo, 1 liter will cost you like $123, the lowest price.
But you will use that same shampoo to wash my hair?
Yes.
So if I was to come here today and say I want a wash and blow dry, I will get the best shampoo?
Yes.
So when I leave, my hair will feel
different. And the extra thing is that we apply a mask in your hair, and you're going to the spa. It's a heater, and that spa will stimulate your growth and will open cuticles. So your hair will get the best treated, the best treatment out of the masks and the oils that we use.
I absolutely love that. We spoke a little bit as well about, or you mentioned that sometimes people suffer hair loss.
Yes.
What can an ordinary person do to minimize that?
Yeah. I think I recommend it personally, and I saw results already. Wash your hair more like daily, because if you accumulate dirt in your scalp, you will see what is really the problem. So wash your hair daily if you have short hair, or if you have and long hair, well, blow dry it after wash.
But
so
every day is better.
Never go sleep with your hair wet or wrap it in towel. Your hair will don't need humidity.
It will rot.
Will have a smell next day or so. So we need to wash it in the morning. Go work with your hair wet, or who cares, right?
Yeah. But you say that will prevent hair loss?
Yes, because it's fresh. You keep your hair fresh, clean. Then not using too much the cap or helmets, or if you're using that, please use a treatment, like every day.
Like when you wash your hair, wash it with a treatment,
yes,
as well. Wow. You know, you make a lot of sense, because I noticed that a lot of people, like, I mean, it's unfortunate that's their job, like the military guys and the traffic men and the police that have to keep that hot on all day. They're the first people to go bald.
Then they go home and they don't have a shampoo, they don't have a...
They just go to bed.
Yes.
They shower and they don't wash their hair,
yes,
and they go to bed.
If you're riding a motorcycle and you have to wear a helmet, or you're a cyclist, you have to put on your helmet to go ride your bicycle. I love cycling. And you can moisturize your hair. After you finish your workout or so, wash your hair, deep clean it, then moisturize it. Keep your leave-in cream in. If you like to just come and treat you here, we have a promotion for anti-hair loss.
You have a promotion for anti-hair loss?
Yes.
How does this promotion work, and when can somebody come to access it?
Yeah, it's a spa treatment. So we wash the hair, then we apply the treatments. It's oil, mask, and ampoules that we will check your hair first, the scalp. If you have any like problem, it's good to come to a salon at least once a month, because I can analyze your hair, your head, the scalp. If you have any scalp problems, we can tell you.
I like the fact that you can, most salons you go into, Sandra, they just wash your hair, they put you under the blow dryer, they comb it out, they whatever, and you're gone. Hair is not like that.
No. You can ask question here. You say, you know what, my scalp is itching, I don't know what's going on. We will analyze it. We will ask you questions, we will check what's happening. We might change your shampoo. We might recommend you to change your shampoo, because this shampoo will dry your scalp. We need to moisturize it, so we will change your shampoo sometimes.
I love that. Some people have their hair just can't grow, or they feel that their hair can't grow. And then they go into the store and they buy all these things they see on YouTube, but it's really not for their type of hair. So you can prevent them from going through all of that.
Yes.
By just coming here.
Yes.
And do you, let's say I walk through the door and I say, you know, Miss Sandra, I want you to have a look at my hair. Would you analyze it for free? And then, like, I just want you to look at it and say, well, it's not growing. Maybe you take 2 minutes to look at it and say, well, this is what I recommend.
Yes, yes, we do that.
She says, yes, yes, we do that. I love it, love it,
yes.
Love it. Are you always here? Because you are the licensed cosmetologist. You are the one that went to study hair. You are the one that has the hair that will stretch and not pop. Everybody would want a hair like that. So are you almost always here?
Yes, I almost always here. But I have my assistants that are professionals also and well-trained.
So if it doesn't matter who gets to look at me, they all know the same answer.
Yes. If you, I have ladies that specialize on nails and pedicure, manicure. I have ladies that specialize on hair. So I am the cosmetologist that does like mostly everything, because I completely train for everything. But I always help them to learn more.
Before we go, I'd like one last tip on one of the things that people with hair like myself can do to make it grow and grow with full body.
Yes. With Afro hair, we treat it. We have ladies that like to apply maybe blonde in their hair. We can do that. But there is a special treatment to follow when you do chemical treatments in your hair. And if you want to keep it healthy, don't iron it much. No heat in your afro, because the afro hair is the most sensitive hair.
Really?
It's the most sensitive hair. My hair, I can flat iron my hair with 450 heat.
Degrees?
Yes, degrees. But the afro, you can't. You will break it, you will burn it. It's the most sensitive hair. That's why if you go to a professional salon, don't make them burn your hair like that, no. You need to learn the type of hair that you will have. Study about it, ask questions, and go to the right place.
Miss Sandra, thank you for stopping in this morning and sharing with us on Wellness Wednesday. I am sure that a lot of people, including myself, got some knowledge. But in the future, if you want to know more about your hair, your face, your skin, your nails, stop in at Sandra's Dream Nail and Day Spa. Their information and is written right on the bottom of the screen here, so you can see the numbers to call and their location. Next week, Wednesday, we will be joining you right from this same location with Miss Sandra, where we will be discussing skin. Until then, we encourage you to have a wonderful day.
Dream Salon Nail Hair and Day Spa, your relaxation and beautification destination. We are a full-service salon. Our services include massage therapy, nail services, skincare and makeup, waxing, hair design and color, and men's barbering. Look and feel fabulous at Dream Salon Nail Hair and Day Spa. Visit us today at 1757 Coney Drive in Belize City.
When you are looking for the widest variety in glass windows and doors, you must visit the pros at Belize Window Mart. They can provide you with tinted glass, clear glass, laminated glass, frosted glass, one-way glass, mirror, sliding windows, single-hung windows, storm guard windows, hurricane shutter, glass louver windows, arches, and showcases. Call them today for a free estimate. They deliver countrywide. Belize Window Mart. Contact them in Spanish Lookout at telephone number 823-0370 or 635-5252. Belize Window Mart, we have the windows to your home.
Relaxing, clean, comfortable, and friendly environment are only a few of the things you can experience at Amigo's Restaurant. We're the ideal place to stuff and fill up on the most tasty meals. Be it breakfast, lunch, or dinner, we have just what your taste buds are asking for. Be sure to ask about our daily special. Amigo's Restaurant, 31 and a half miles George Price Highway, where friends meet.
Looking for quality and affordable fashion? The It Store, where you can shop fashion for less. We have clothing for the entire family and quality that fits your budget. The number one store in town. Find kids, men, and women apparel for all occasions. We are located at the number one Queen Street, Belize City. Call us at 223-1552. Remember to like us on Facebook. The It Store. Find it, love it, buy it for less.
At West Track Belize City, we are looking to help you save both your time and money. We've also improved our stock levels to ensure we have everything you might need for your automotive or agricultural needs. Additionally, West Track has added heavy duty and industrial parts to keep your trucks and equipment running. At West Track Belize City, we understand that your time is important, so we want to bring our services to you at your convenience. Now you can simply send us a message on WhatsApp or Facebook, and we will be right there to help with any questions you may have.
As I always say, work hard, play hard. For those of you with a more rugged side, outdoor activities include fishing, hiking, bicycle and horseback riding, canoeing and kayaking, and crocodile spotting. We also include off-site connections for zip lining, cave tubing, snorkeling, and scuba diving in Belize's beautiful barrier reef. Or be like me, relax and enjoy the exhilarating tour of the Belize River.
Just drive.
Just drive.
Have love. Just drive. Let us at Caribbean Tire take care of everything else. We want you to enjoy the drive, and that is why we're offering free tire inspection, free fluid checkup, free oil change with the purchase of oils and filters, and free battery checkup. Available at all Caribbean Tire branches countrywide. Just drive. Caribbean Tire, taking you home safely.
Me and my Marie Sharp in Indiana.
I'm in Redondo Beach, California with my Marie Sharp.
Me and my Marie Sharps in Kabul, Afghanistan.
Me and my Marie Sharp that are Hertfordshire, England.
Me and my Marie Sharps in Taipei, Taiwan.
Marie Sharp, world-class products produced in Belize.
New Buildings Limited is the company of choice when it comes to design, fabricating, and erection of wide-span metal buildings in Belize. At New Buildings, we have a team of well-trained professionals that can produce the most innovative and durable metal structures. Be it domestic or industrial buildings, we can get it done for you. We have put together some of the most outstanding metal structures in the country. We also do estimates and consulting. Visit New Buildings in Spanish Lookout or give them a call at 631-8723 or 610-5185. New Buildings Limited, the experts when it comes to metal structures in Belize.
Welcome to Timber Cube Limited, Belize's first modern wood furniture and art gallery. Our gallery specializes in modern furnitures, customized gifts and souvenirs, and unique wood awards. The gallery aims to attract lovers of contemporary furniture, minimalism, as well as a little of the traditional. It is the place to visit for that one piece of furniture, carving, painting, or souvenir that will separate you from the ordinary. Come visit us at Mile 59, Unitedville Village, Cayo District.
So nice,
Caribbean pride.
Need you in a me life,
Caribbean pride.
So nice, 100% Belizean, 100% pure and natural.
Yeah, for the young and the old, for the rich and the poor, we drinking Caribbean pride.
Yeah,
for the hot and the cold, so me want a little more, and me not tell no lie.
So nice,
Caribbean pride.
Need you in a me life,
Caribbean pride.
So nice,
well alright.
Tell them we drinking Caribbean pride, orange juice, or get the grapefruit. Sweet and unsweet, and you can choose. Get the apple, the pineapple, the fruit punch, just pop the bottle. Yeah, quality in every sip. Me tell you how me taste the pride in every drip. Yeah, Caribbean pride number one. Tell them we drinking Caribbean pride.
Mothers, a few minutes ago we had Wellness Wednesday. That was our first Wellness Wednesday, and that will continue to be the norm each and every Wednesday. But now after that, that is your physical well-being, your mental well-being, and now we're going to feed your emotional well-being. We have the guys from Jankuna Production in studio with us now. Good morning, ladies.
Morning. Good to be back.
The last time we saw you was around Christmas time. You had a play. And now you have a new play.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But for the people that may not know who you are, I can't imagine after the amazing work that you have been doing in terms of theatre over the past few months in Belize, kindly introduce yourself again for us, please.
Julianne Ellis Bradley, co-founder of Jankuna Productions.
And Sandra McKee, co-founder of Jankuna Productions.
You two ladies, when people used to see you before, whenever I associate either of you with acting, we associate you with the finances where insurance and that kind of stuff is concerned, and you are a lawyer.
Yes.
I'm sure that you're going to court today or the Confon court or something, somewhere in between that. Let me start with you, Miss Sandra.
Mm-hmm.
What got you involved in this line of work?
16 years ago.
Okay.
16 years ago when, by happenstance, I should say, I was in Jamaica and was in a theater, seeing a play and enjoying it, and read that the play could be used as a fundraiser, brought the idea to my Rotary Club, and the rest is history. I've been doing this for the last 16 years for fun and for free, so that the public could enjoy theater in Belize more frequently than we were accustomed to. And then my dear friend and I spoke after the last Rotary play, River Bottom. Well, now Cruffy Air was the last one, but the one prior to this was River Bottom. Julian and I spoke about doing this as a company, having founded Jankuna Productions, decided to offer theatre at a business level so that it could be sustainable and that the Belizean public, who is well deserving of these kind of high quality productions, would now have it on a more frequent basis.
Yeah.
So it all started out by doing it for charity, and they say, as you sow, you reap. No?
Well, yeah. Obviously you are in the reaping end now.
Yes.
And Mrs. Bradley?
And for me, theatre has been a part of my life, maybe from the age of 10. And it's really has been an outlet and a passion for me. And I got a chance to just reignite that passion when I volunteered my time last year with the Rotary effort in River Bottom. Mm-hmm. A few years before, I've always had the idea, I've always wanted to do theater and to do it in a meaningful way. And this time I said, I saw Sandra, I saw her passion, and I said, I think this will be a good team. And there are so many talented people in Belize, and the theater is there. It's people deserve good theater in Belize, and I think that there's a way for us to pull our energies mm-hmm. together. I had an idea, a script I was working on from well before River Bottom. It took me almost a year to put Belize Rewind together, and Sandra had the time, and she had all the other skills, and I said this would be a match made in heaven.
You know, I go to your play. I went to the play that you had over the weekend, and that you're probably going to be having
Crawford
again,
Air.
Crawford Air, this mm-hmm. weekend, and I listened to the script. And then I say, you know why? You know why you do so good? Because you're part Jamaican and part Belizean. So the combination really, really works. I mean, you did an amazing job at scripting this script.
Thank you.
Like you did
much.
The last time. I mean, and you match the characters to
the right people.
To the script. Exactly. Yeah. I mean, when you go there, you have to go and see. Not because I say so, but because that's so. You know, when you see Rajani on stage,
oh yes,
it is like, it is really her.
Yeah.
Yes. And that is the beauty about Rajani. Rajani, and everybody knows Rajani as a wonderful singer. She
yes.
has a beautiful voice. But Rajani, and this is one of the things Jankunda Productions, she was not really for acting, but she has that talent, and we were able to help her to bring that to the fore.
She accuses me of forcing her. She said, thank you for forcing me to do
thank
this.
Thank you for forcing me.
Because now, you know, that inner talent has
yes.
emerged.
And she's so good at it. And we have Tremet. Perriott, her
yes.
brother, who sings and acts very well. And that's one of the things we want to do, to continue to have that platform to showcase the best of the Belizean talent.
Well, we're not going to get into where people can see this play and all that yet, because you have to listen to the whole show to figure all of that out. But what I'll ask is, how do you, for other young people out there, or people in general, because you have from little people in this play, the only thing you never have that real baby, but soon we'll have a talking real baby. But you have young, middle age, and old. And there are some older people out there that has the talent, but they have no outlets.
Yes.
How can they access you?
We have an ongoing recruitment at Jankunda Productions. We want to take the vision to setting up Jankunda Youths, for example, where we start to kindle that love for theater and acting and the arts in the schools. And if you need to, if you have a talent, be it singing, acting, dancing, you contact us.
610-4282. And we're always looking for talent. We're always scouting. So we're always interested in hearing about persons who may want to be a part of our team. Because as Julian was saying, we plan to keep this ongoing. So whether you look at the productions that we have not yet produced, we would be looking for persons when those come to the fore. Even as we have these productions running, from time to time we may need to, you know, get reinforcement in one area or the other because somebody might need to travel abroad or whatever the case may be. So we are always interested in hearing about persons who may want to join our team. You did pass a comment though. You said that you noticed we have young people, middle age and old, but we have no old people.
Well, now that you
say
that.
Yes.
I was in no
way. Just thought I would clarify that.
You know what the song say? The song say, I throw the con, but I will call no foul.
Exactly.
So if the foul show up, then I'm my fault.
Right. They have going ball and what are going to be their sleep.
Yes.
Right.
Right. And actually, I was referring to what could possibly be, or who could possibly be your husband.
Oh! And then again, he's not old. Well, not, you know,
right.
to my knowledge.
But let me say this, that one of the things I want to put out there is that we're not only looking for people who live in the Lee City. If you are in other districts, reach out to us. If you are in the South, for example, we want to hear from you. So don't believe that because we are, most of the productions happen at the Bliss, that it's just limited to Belize City.
It's true. I mean, and I think that you come up with this idea in a very amazing place called Belize because you have all sorts of people.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I mean, you have a good mix. You will find a Spanish man, a Creole man, an Indian woman.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you have a great mix. So the next time we should see, I can't even imagine an even more amazing show.
Oh my gosh. Prepare to be amazed.
The pressure is on. So when is this show showing again and where?
All right. Well, we have this Thursday of this week, which is April 11th. And it's at the Bliss, 7 p.m. Subsequent to that, we will be back at the Bliss on the 11th of May, as well as the 22nd of May, mm-hmm. and then the 25th of June. So those dates are on our Facebook page, Jankuna Productions, and J-A-N-K-U-N-U, and Productions with a Z at the end instead of an S. Go on our Facebook page and you will see the upcoming dates, but it's this Thursday, April 11th, 7 p.m. at the Bliss, $50, $30, $20 are the prices of the tickets. So we're expecting persons to really, you know, come in droves, and it's already happening. The tickets are being sold very fast. Yes.
And they posted for the district dates.
And then the district dates, we have Belmopan coming up, Independence,
Dangriga, and Orange Walk.
Orange Walk, that's the other one. So Belmopan, Orange Walk, and Independence would be the first three of district shows. Just look out for the dates on our page again, and then we go to the other areas as well. We'll be in San Pedro with Belize Rewind this Friday.
Okay. Where in San Pedro?
At the Paradise Theatre. 7 o'clock in San Pedro this Friday, April 12th. So Cruffy Air, April 11th, Thursday at the Bliss. Belize Rewind, Friday, April 12th in San Pedro. Paradise Theatre, 7 p.m. So we are keeping very busy.
You
and
guys
our cast,
are busy.
Yeah, our cast members are very happy because, as Julian rightly said, I mean, there are persons out there with these talents, with these gifts. You talk about a Rajani and a Tremet and a Moafrika Haynes and so many persons who Wani Arzu. Wani is not from Belize City, but he's a part of our team. So case in point, you don't have to live in Belize City to be a part of our team, okay? And we're looking at the fact that these are persons who have a passion for the arts. I would rather be doing that than a 9-to-5, you know, that you have
than
to do.
Than Salapina Court?
And Salapina Court. I talk about the people in Salapina Court because, I mean, I'm hearing a passion that far,
it's
far more fulfilling and supersedes that. But if that is what they want to do, that is what they ought to be doing, and that's the kind of avenue that we are providing for them in Jankuna Productions.
What is your motivation, or what was your motivation for this play? I mean, you have to go and see it. I mean, I every time I want to ask you a question, I have to caution myself because I just want to tell everybody how amazing it is by giving the examples. But I'm telling you, from the time you sit down till it's done, you will be laughing. Right. So what is your motivation? I mean, what do you think about when you go home that evening to make you come up with their lines?
I take motivation from everyday life. I think when I see something happen, it's the weirdest thing. I will be sitting in court, something happens, and I'm like, get up my phone
make
and
note.
I make a note. I make a note.
Yes.
I make a note. I will be in the supermarket, anywhere. Everything becomes, because one of the things that was very important is to see ourselves on stage. I mean, we can watch TV, we can watch all the North American and other countries and the wonderful things that they do, but there's nothing that compares to seeing yourself on stage. And sometimes I'm just blown away by just the drama of everyday life in the least.
I mean, when you think of the, especially in this play, I can see myself on that flight.
Right.
I can see myself on that flight.
In which character was it?
Definitely not take a note. I am not there to take notes.
You're not Miss Bourgeois.
No, I'm not Miss Bourgeois. I'm not there to take notes. Very sorry. But I probably, you know, maybe the pregnant one.
Okay. Right.
And many others.
I mean, I tell you, you have to definitely go to enjoy the play. I mean, definitely. Where can people buy tickets?
At the Bliss. Mm-hmm. So the tickets are available at the Bliss. And of course, on our page, you can call any of the members of Jankuna Productions, 610-4282, 615-4282. Mm-hmm. And reserve your tickets. We can deliver or you can pick up.
So. Excellent. Mm-hmm. So this Thursday, which is tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock.
Correct.
Make sure you are at the Bliss to be entertained like no other way. You understand me? And make sure you wear something comfortable.
All right.
Not got it all to stush because you will be laughing. you know what? Pop nothing.
All right.
You understand? Right. Got it comfortably dressed. Mm-hmm. I think Serena's Cafe probably will be open in the evening after that.
And her snacks are fabulous.
Yes.
So,
and we will have a brief intermission so that you can enjoy
the snacks.
Some of the
brownies,
wonderful
the smoothies, the cookies, the chips and dips. lovely snacks in intermission time. So you have a lovely night out to look forward to. Make it a date. Bring out the whole family, from the oldest to the youngest. It's a family show.
It is a family show, and I like the fact that it is a family show.
Yes.
It's nice, clean, and funny.
Exactly.
What we're going to do, though, we're going to take a break and be back.
Dream Salon Nail Hair and Day Spa, your relaxation and beautification destination. We are a full-service salon. Our services include massage therapy, nail services, skincare and makeup, waxing, hair design and color, and men's barbering. Look and feel fabulous at Dream Salon Nail Hair and Day Spa. Visit us today at 1757 Coney Drive in Belize City.
As I always say, work hard, play hard. For those of you with a more rugged side, outdoor activities include fishing, hiking, bicycle and horseback riding, canoeing and kayaking, and crocodile spotting. We also include off-site connections for zip lining, cave tubing, snorkeling, and scuba diving in Belize's beautiful Barrier Reef. Or be like me, relax and enjoy the exhilarating tour of the Belize River.
Just drive.
Just drive.
Just drive. Let us at Caribbean Tire take care of everything else. We want you to enjoy the drive, and that is why we're offering free tire inspection, free fluid checkup, free oil change with the purchase of oils and filters, and free battery checkup. Available at all Caribbean Tire branches countrywide. Just drive. Caribbean Tire, taking you home safely.
Me and my Marie Sharp in Indiana.
I'm in Rhonda Beach, California, with my Marie Sharp.
Me and my Marie Sharp in Kabul, Afghanistan.
Me and my Marie Sharp that are Hertfordshire, England.
Me and my Marie Sharps in Taipei, Taiwan.
Marie Sharp, world-class products produced in Belize.
New Buildings Limited is the company of choice when it comes to design, fabricating, and erection of wide-span metal buildings in Belize. At New Buildings, we have a team of well-trained professionals that can produce the most innovative and durable metal structures. Be it domestic or industrial buildings, we can get it done for you. We have put together some of the most outstanding metal structures in the country. We also do estimates and consulting. Visit New Buildings in Spanish Lookout or give them a call at 631-8723 or 610-5185. New Buildings Limited, the experts when it comes to metal structures in Belize.
Welcome to Timber Cube Limited, Belize's first modern wood furniture and art gallery. Our gallery specializes in modern furnitures, customized gifts and souvenirs, and unique wood awards. The gallery aims to attract lovers of contemporary furniture, minimalism, as well as a little of the traditional. It is the place to visit for that one piece of furniture, carving, painting, or souvenir that will separate you from the ordinary. Come visit us at Mile 59, Unitedville Village, Cayo District.
So nice,
Caribbean pride.
Need you in my life,
Caribbean pride.
So nice, 100% Belizean, 100% pure and natural.
Yeah, for the young and the old, for the rich and the poor, we drinking Caribbean pride.
Yeah,
for the hot and the cold, so me want a little more, and me not tell no lie.
So nice,
Caribbean pride.
Need you in my life,
Caribbean.
So nice,
well alright.
Tell them we drinking Caribbean pride. Orange juice, or get the grapefruit. Sweet and unsweet and you can choose. Get the apple, the pineapple, the fruit punch, just pop the bottle. Yeah, quality in every sip. Me tell you how me taste the pride in every drip. Yeah, Caribbean pride number one. Tell them we drinking Caribbean pride.
is a city. I have to remind you that when you're looking for a vehicle to drive, let it be one from Caribbean Motors, especially the Wingo 6, as the Wingo 6 has a $5,000 free fuel promotion. If you don't want a Wingo 6, I can't imagine why. You can drive a Haval or anything that they have. Stop in and check them out. Everybody in this country can drive a brand new vehicle if you were to just stop in, find out the details at Caribbean Motors. Ladies, welcome back.
Good to be back.
Good to be back.
Well, now that we get all of that out of the way for a short time, it's time to jump into people's matters. But I don't want to go into the general, to the matters that come in right away, because it's not every day that we get professionals on the set. So I figure we might as well talk a little bit about real issues that can affect people, that really give them some free advice this morning so that they could say, you know, I get something today. Mm-hmm. What is your specialty?
I specialize in, we actually do general civil matters, and I focus a lot on real estate, probate, and also a little, I love mediation as well.
How effective is mediation?
Mediation is very effective because it allows the parties to resolve their dispute in a way that works for them. The challenge is that, and it's something that's very strange, because people go to court a lot to feel powerful, but it actually should be the point of last resort. Because when you go to court, you hand over all the power to determine your dispute to a third party, the judge. And mediation allows the parties to take that dispute back and decide how best can we resolve it. When the judge decides it, the judge has to look at the letter of the law, the black and white. But you are the persons in the circumstance. You get to determine how my relationship with this person going forward will be framed in terms of, because litigation is very hard on relationships, very hard on families, neighbors, if you have a business relationship. And so mediation is really a superior means of resolving disputes.
So if somebody was to come to you and say, Mrs. Bradley, this is my issue, how do you get them to mediation?
Okay, so mediation can be done even if you're not in court. But even in court now, it is a part of the process where the judge can refer the matter to mediation. Anybody, there are several persons who have been trained in Belize to mediate. And you can call maybe the Chamber of Commerce or the University of the West Indies or Restore Belize. And the court also has a list of trained mediators on its website. So you can contact a mediator and have that mediator assist.
When somebody is in a dispute that is as big as their land, their home, their wife, their husband, their dog, their children, and most of the time one party is more educated than the other party. Mm-hmm. So the party that is educated will come to you and, you know, say, Sandra, you know, make we got a mediation. Me, I never heard the word before. I don't know what it is. I feel like you'll trick me. Mm-hmm. How can you communicate that to somebody that is not, that is fearful, that you don't need to spend $5,000 from a lawyer? You could just go to these people, and through conversation and communication, you can get to your end goal. Mm-hmm.
Yes, the mediators are highly trained and qualified, and this is why I say go to the institutions that have trained or certified mediators, and then you'll be able to know that the person who is coming to assist me is somebody who knows what they're doing and understands the ethics, because there are code of ethics that the mediators have to abide by.
Is the mediator costly?
It's very inexpensive at the moment, relatively speaking, particularly if you're looking at court costs. At the mediations, some mediations happen, some people do it as a part of community service and there is no charge. Sometimes there is a cost, and at the court it is subsidized. But you get to agree with your mediator what the rate is and what the cost is that that mediator charges.
Well, that is wonderful to know. Ms. Sandra, now let's talk a little bit about money. Mm. A lot of people are out there, and this is coming up to the... I mean, they're out there and they don't understand the importance of insurance, let's say, for instance. We know that that is where you were for a very long time. Mm. And they feel that if they don't insure or insure, there are pros and cons and they feel all confused. But let's talk about a special kind of insurance, medical insurance. Mm-hmm. Because I was one of the ones that used to say, you know, I don't need that.
Okay.
I'm young and nothing wrong with me.
Nothing broke down yet.
Not only broke down, but nothing never looked like me and broke down anytime soon.
Yeah.
Once you get into your 40s and you start to think, when is a good time to start insurance?
The truth is, from your very first paycheck is the best time to start putting insurances in place. Now, it might not be that you would go for the medical insurance first, because we do have a chart, if, as it were, you know, that we take you down and say, well, you know, first things first. However, if we teach our young people to plan, then certainly a part of financial planning, part and parcel would be insurance. And the reason being, it's like you said, we always have this sense of being invincible.
I man.
Nothing's going to happen to me. Things could pop up at any age. So planning is key. And what insurance does, it helps you to have access to lump sums of money in many cases, especially in serious circumstances like health, that you would not ordinarily have been able to save were you to be setting aside a piece of that paycheck every month. So that's the reason why from the first paycheck, if you were to put a portion of it into insurance, then you immediately have access to what we call a pool. Because the whole concept behind insurance is a pooling of similar risks. Planning to build your home, can you imagine you can do that with an insurance plan?
A lot of people don't know that.
But people are not aware that those are the kind of things that come with insurance planning. So insurance can help you to plan in just about every area of life.
Mm-hmm. Let me switch back to you for a little bit, because the business that I am in, I only get bad news. Mm. Nobody texts Morning Matters to say I'm happily married.
Yeah.
Nobody texts Morning Matters
I'll
to say...
I'll do that in the morning.
Please. You know, nobody... But a lot of times when people get into relationships, even though they are not married, they treat their relationships as if they
yes.
are. Mm-hmm. And I feel that most of the time, the man will say he's the one with the biggest burden. The woman will say she's the one with the biggest burden. Mm-hmm. So two of them left discontented and hurt, and somebody's pocket is hurting. For a person that is getting into a relationship and both of them have financial contribution, mm-hmm. What would be the best way for them to maneuver and navigate the situation without getting themselves too involved too quickly, and then what?
Right. So always it's a challenge, because and we know from watching many movies about prenuptial agreements and
yes.
so on. But in Belize, it's not the law. It does not specifically provide for prenuptial agreements.
We think it's for Americans.
It sounds like something that movie stars do, right?
Yes.
But more and more we find that there are issues which had the parties addressed their minds in writing before the dispute came about, it would have assisted. And people generally think that it's for people with a lot of money that puts prenuptial agreements in place. Like I said, the law does not specifically provide for prenuptial agreements, and at the end of the day, it's the court that's going to determine any weight to be put on any agreement that the parties have entered into. And so until the law changes, it still helps to have something rather than to be relying on he said, she said. People need to start to have that discussion when they realize that they're moving towards serious investments.
You know, because you're a lawyer, it seems so black and white to you. But when you're the lie down with this man or this woman, depending on who the person is, it becomes, I don't want to tell them because I don't want to feel like I just stay in at this for the money or the body
yes,
or whatever
yes,
the case is.
Yes.
How do you communicate that in a way without offending the other person? And additional to that, there are some cases where we don't feel like we have no need for prenuptial because two of we come in with little or nothing.
Yes.
I can work hard and you had the shop. Let's
right.
go sell the shop.
Yes.
The shop, first, you only made to sell bread, bun, and bananas. Now me, I say, you know what, I want to start to bring plants, I want to do whatever it is, and I want to build
and
up
you
the
grow
shop.
The business.
And I grow the business. The only thing you know how to do that, make bread and bun and bananas. Me, I bring in all sorts of things. I import medicine, whatever
right.
it is that
right.
I do. 5 years down the road, now we're not getting on.
Yes.
How do we prevent the argument to get to 5 years?
And that's the thing. Because people's contributions are not, sometimes equity is not equality. And many times when it gets to the point of splitting things, people start to look at what I put in and what you put in. And the intangible contributions, unfortunately, are not always seen as valuable as the in-kind tangible. So if I put a lot of money in the business and I can show that I paid for this and paid for that, it somehow seems that you contributed more. But question that needs to be asked is, when you were putting that money in, what was the understanding when you were putting that in? And what was the other person doing? Because sometimes you may say, I spent all the time in the business, but the other person may have spent, and it's not only women, sometimes it's men,
yes,
spent a lot of time raising the children, keeping the home, making sure that things could happen so that you can focus on what you're good at. So it's about the conversation as to what do we bring to the relationship and how do we value it. And that's the difficulty the court has sometimes. It's a very difficult task the court has sometimes to determine how do we put and weigh in the balance the contributions of the male or the female in a relationship when they have decided to part, when they themselves never did sit down and say, this is what this means for our union. Well, how does the court then value it at the end?
I don't know. Was it meaning that every year you reassess and you say, okay, this is where we are, this is what I work, this is what you work? I don't know.
That's the thing.
But it's really a real issue. So, especially when you are not legally married. Because there are lots of people out there that are, I am married to Tom Jones and you are married to Mary Jane, mm-hmm, and we decide to coexist because we've been married to them for 20 years and we've been separated and we don't consider them our wives or our husbands anymore. Or really they are.
Yes. And so the common law effect doesn't kick in either. And you ask the question about how do you start that discussion? Well, maybe one way to start is, I was watching Morning Matters. And they, you know, strangely enough, they had a conversation. What would happen to us in this circumstance, you know? And start to have that conversation. But I think sometimes just by a matter of, because I love this person, and don't be surprised, many professionals and people who should know better don't necessarily have their affairs in order. They really do go by the way I feel about someone and really believe that it's going to be forever. If you ask yourself, do you have a will? Most people don't. Some people think that it expedites their death if they write a will. But it creates so many problems for the families that are left after the interment. Then the problems start.
How important is a will, especially for somebody that feel that they don't have much?
I think a will is very important, and it's such an inexpensive document to put together that it helps for you to have one.
Where the will is concerned, how effective is the will if I wrote the will today and got married tomorrow?
Okay, so the law in Belize does have a provision that causes marriage to invalidate a will unless that will is made in contemplation of that marriage. And there is actually a case before the Court of Appeal dealing with that particular issue. So if you get married, you need to write another will unless that will was made in contemplation, and not only you thinking about it, but you actually have to express it in that will. You have to say it in that
when
way.
When I get married, X, Y,
like,
and Z.
I am planning to marry Mary Jane. And so it has, the will itself has to say it, because that's the only way the court is going to be able to be sure that you did not want for this will. Because the thinking of the law is that when you get married, you would not want to not provide for your spouse. And so it says that once you get married, things change. And if you don't plan to provide, or you want these things that you've done before to stay in place, then you need to say it. Otherwise, the law wipes it clean and then you have to make another will.
Well, ladies, thank you for this information this morning. But before you go, you cannot go without not telling me what's happening tomorrow evening and where. Miss Sandra?
Well, Cruffy Air, musical comedy. Jankuna Productions will be at the Bliss, 7 p.m. And doors will close at 7 p.m. The show will start, so be on time. Flight departs on time. So we are encouraging everybody to come to the Bliss this Thursday, April 11th, 7 p.m. Tickets are available at the Bliss or by calling 610-4282 or 615-4282. $50, $30, and $20 tickets are available. It's for the whole family, so we're expecting to see a packed house Thursday evening.
Ladies, thank you very much. Guys, until next time, we encourage you to take care of yourselves and each other. This is Rhonda along with
Julianne,
Sandra McKay.
Saying goodbye.